Welcome back to the Crooked Spine Show. When you're overly stressed, what happens to your body? Do you feel tight? Do you have headaches? Do you feel soreness where it won't go away? In today's talk with Sebastian Reis out of Frankfurt, Germany, he is a certified energy healer in Germany. He explains how this happens and how to get rid of the underlying problems making your body stay tight, stay sore, and feel better again. It is proven that the body's internal energy is self-healing and looks to stay in balance when healthy. This is his philosophy. This is chiropractic philosophy. This is a natural medicine type of philosophy where the body can heal itself because it can self-regulate and self-heal. Emotions, when they get trapped in the physical body, it can block this energy that controls our healing, have external and extra and internal pains. Today, Sebastian helps understand exactly how to release this trapped emotion in our body, maybe from a previous injury as a kid, emotional or physical trauma, even as an adult too, where it's blocking your ability to have a normal, healthy life now. In this highlights of the talk, we talk about exactly how we identify this trapped emotion, how do we understand what's happening behind the emotion, how to release it, and then move on so you don't hold on to it. This is antithesis or opposite of what sometimes therapists will do with people to where they continue to remember the source of the problem versus letting it go completely. In this talk, we talk about also too, Sebastian and I, exactly what it means when energy goes where tension is. We want to make sure as our body releases the energy, it doesn't come back that emotional state. By doing certain things as meditation, as taking walks by ourselves, by, if you want to call it, listening to our internal self, helps understand how to stay relaxed, how to stay healthy, and maintain that for a while becomes our overall normal. At that point, our inside body can stay healed, have positive energy, keep our body staying healthy for the long run. All right, so hope you enjoy the talk. Go to the show notes to look specific topics for one too. Also, connect to Sebastian. He works worldwide since a lot of stuff can be done on Zoom or online, even in person, to understand how you can help your body heal, especially long term, if you haven't found, or even if you found other ways to help your body heal. All right, so do I talk to my friends? Find people that can help you feel better, heal better, and I'll see you next week. All right, this is a talk with Sebastian Reis in Germany. This topic is the body-mind connection. And what I put in there was really understanding when you're stressed, what do you feel? What I mean by that, do you feel tight shoulders? Do you have headaches? Do you have back pain? And how does that connect with your stress level and what's going on with your body's inside? Maybe long-term chronic, if we want to call it fatigue or anxiety or stress, or short-term stress too. So Sebastian Reis is going to go through as he's based in Germany. He's an international healer working all over Europe and all the parts of the world. I like his bio because he understands something I've delved into but not really understand myself. So I want him to explain, how does the body connect together? How do we get to those links between emotions and physical pain? And biggest thing is, how do we fix that, Sebastian? What do we do? All right, so Sebastian, give us a quick idea of what your background is and how you got into this.
Okay, thank you so much, Tony. Hi people, greetings to you. Nice to come in here. So a bit about myself. Yeah, well, I started as an electrician and I absolutely hated it. And I was looking for my soul purpose all time, you know, and I had a really long, struggling way to come here. And, you know, like, I had a lot of pain when I was in the fitness, in the gym, right? So I looked up all the stuff online, and through that, my own struggles, I came to physiotherapy then, and I started doing that. And then I was kind of like on the right track, but I was not fully 100% satisfied. So then I discovered through my own near-death experience, where I had an asthma attack in the night, I had this calling that, you know, there's something other than the physical. And, you know, because my SOS medication, the strong one, the spray, that it didn't work twice, and it should, and it always worked, right? So then I went up to my parents, and it immediately stopped, like when I entered the room. So I knew it was because I had this attack because of them, but they also protect me, and that's why it stopped. So I was kind of like questioning, okay, what is going on? So then I dived into the psycho-emotional like therapies, and I found out that asthma is about pressure. Okay, it's about pressuring yourself and other giving you pressure, other people from the outside, so you don't have enough room breathing on your chest. Okay, it's like a heavy weight on your chest. So I found that very interesting, and then you know I started my own healing journey. I had a dance friend, and like I'm doing a couple dance as well, and he introduced me to energy healing lady, where I had an appointment with her also over the phone. Like my friend, he had success working with her on his problems, so he recommended me to that lady. And you know, I had these heartache problems, like emotional kind of problems, and she just like released some emotions, and she found out where are they from, what's the emotion called. And she did that with kinesiology. So some people are familiar with a muscle test, maybe, right? It's working with the subconscious mind. So it's like, maybe some people know also a pendulum, where you swing in horizontally and vertically. So you can get yes or no answers if you ask, okay, is it that year or that emotion? So that's how you kind of diagnose and detect those things. It works also online, because everyone has an energetic telephone number, kind of. You can see it like that. And I can just connect to the people through the subconscious mind. So the subconscious mind is 95% working in the background. So we are just conscious, aware of our programs or emotions, just to 5%. So, that's so key, because you can access 95% of hidden beliefs or traumas or emotions, and that's what I release and work on. And that's why it's so effective in going to the root, right? Yeah.
When, how do you become a, if you want to call it, a patient of energy healing, to a energy healing healer itself? How do you become a practitioner of that? How did that work?
Yeah, I had this first session with that lady, and it was mind-blowing. Like after the session already, I felt lighter. Like after the next few days, I felt much more lighter again in my heart, in that topic, what we worked on, like emotionally, just more relaxed, right? And so I had these big changes only after one session, like 60 minutes. And I also had never done that before. It was first time for me. And then I thought, okay, I'm gonna do more sessions with her. All right, and like I had three more, and like it kind of was done, almost done, my topic. All right, okay. It was big time emotionally lighter for me, and it was not in, like before it was 100% issue for me, and then you know I had this heartache problems kind of, and after it was maybe like 10%, you know. So I thought, okay, I got to check this out. I want to learn that myself. So it was kind of like I experienced how good it is and how fast it works, because I did like psychotherapy, and it was worsening my issues. Just talk about the problem every week, 1 hour. You make it bigger and bigger and bigger, because you talk 1 hour every time about the negative, right? And with that work, with the energy healing, you detect the problems, how big they are, when they are created, and then you just release them. It's not talk therapy, right? It's like you do something about it. So you kind of like, yeah, change your beliefs, and you're kind of like, then you attract different things and people and situations, and think differently about yourself and the world. So
almost like resetting your if you want to call it your background, to erase or release that, so now you can fill with something that's more positive.
Yep, totally, totally. It's like you install the negative beliefs, mm-hmm. and you find them out because they're subconsciously right through that muscle testing, through that kinesiology. Because sometimes you're not aware of your beliefs, right? Because your conscious mind, as I said, can just access 5%, right? You are just aware of 5% of your issues. And the subconscious mind, where I can work with and detect, I can detect the other 95%. So then I delete kind of like these negative beliefs and install positive ones. And how it is done is you just kind of use the meridian system, the governing meridian it's called, and it's running from the top of your head kind of like through the whole back, and it's connected to all other meridians. And the meridian is kind of an energy system where your energy is flowing and everything is also kind of safe in. And when you swipe three times like over your head, kind of like this, okay, and then you can just release those things. And then people usually kind of yawn. They yawn, and then you see, okay, it's been released. They kind of like let out the negative belief or the emotion. And then I can just muscle test again, or with a pendulum. You know, you can detect if it's been released. And
And the meridian system is basically, from a scientific perspective, is more of a nervous system, correct?
That's a part as well, of course. Mm-hmm. The nervous system is very, very important, big, of course. But it's more so than it works not on your only on your physical body. It works on all of your body. So there's an emotional body as well, which you don't see. It's kind of the aura, right? If people can detect the aura nowadays with Killian photography, you might have heard of this. And then you can like detect the aura and the color and the shape and where there are problems also. So it's kind of like an energy field that's non-visible around your body, like 3 meters in all directions. And there's where the problems are located. And we release them out of there, because if they are, firstly, they are created in the emotional body, kind of, right? And then they manifest in the physical body.
Okay.
So that means before you have cancer, a lot of stuff has to happen so you can have cancer, right? So that means, I don't know, like you have a lot of toxins for years, you drink, you are not happy, you are not happy with your job, like you do that for 10 years and you don't do sports and you smoke and all that things, like you're putting it all on your body, right? And then it manifests in the physical, but it's not like a switch and it's there, the cancer, like you have to do a lot of things wrong with it.
Good. And when you work with clients, what's a common thing that you work with someone trying to work through, what emotion or what physical pain?
Yeah. So for example, it could be like that maybe your parents weren't like one of your parents was not physically there, right? And that means like you could attract, if your dad was not around, you could attract then people in your outer life. Like you could have problems with male people, right? Because the dad was not around, and that is saved in your subconscious mind that you have kind of like you don't deserve love from a dad because he was not around, and that's kind of like saved like these emotions and beliefs in your subconscious mind. So people have then struggle with like every kind of relationship, right? Romantic or business related or friends, because they haven't healed this, and it's a trauma imprinted from the young age, okay? Because it's very susceptible, the body and the subconscious mind when we're younger. And like it's multifaceted, like people come with emotional problems or with business problems also, like, you know, you could have a bad belief about, like, I don't deserve to have a lot of money, right? And I could delete that and install that with, you know, I deserve to have a lot of money, for example, other ones. People have relationship problems, divorce or something, or their kids, they come a lot with their kids also to me. They want help for their kids because they have struggle learning in school, right? So, yeah, or maybe, you know, people had also knee pain. So how to explain, right? How can I work with the emotions on physical pain? How does that work maybe? Yeah, maybe the watchers will question that. So to explain this is like, you have for 2 years knee pain, and every day you are angry about yourself and the world and your knee, and then this anger is lodged, trapped, we say trapped emotion, it's trapped in your energy field, and then it's recreated every day and put more on it, put more on it, put more anger on it, put more anger on it. So it's like 100 times this anger emotion is then placed in that area. And so it gets worse and worse and worse. And I release then the anger emotion out of there. And then it gets easier, right? Usually it takes a few days to process as well. So like 2 to 3 days. And yeah, so actually it's like almost 95 to 99% of people have betterment, or it's like after a few sessions it's gone, because it's just like on the deeper level, and a lot of people just work on the physical body and they are not aware that there's something else. So it's very efficient, because it's another way, right? Not a lot of people have tried it, kind of like
you're almost getting to, okay, why is the person angry, and is the knee the issue? So you're trying to, as any practitioner would, figure out everything what's going on. If someone has no results from knee therapy and what's going on there, at that point, is there? It's been scientifically proven there's a body mind connection. If our mind is telling our body to stay angry, and that knee is that, in my sense, the interpreter, let me know, Sebastian, is now my knee becomes the source of the anger. Take away the angry knee. At that point, the body now can heal and now find a different source to feel different emotions. Is that correct?
Yeah, totally. Perfect. Mm-hmm. Awesome. Yep. Then the question is, like, why is he angry, right? Or why did the knee pain start, at least, right? So that could be like a lot of things, but if it's like, you can interpret diseases like I did with the asthma about pressure, right? You pressure yourself, like you can imagine like this heavy thing, like a heavy car on your chest, okay? You make that car yourself with your life struggle, with your own thoughts or other people, because they expect you to be like that and that. And you feel a victim, and then you pressure yourself so much. And if it's on the foot or the knee or something, you can say like, okay, that means like he has struggle moving forward in life, right? Something like that. Mm-hmm. It doesn't always have to be like that, but it's like pretty much most of the time, or like at least, I don't know, 70%, it could be for some people that it is because of that. So they don't know where to go. They kind of like feel trapped, like, what should I do? I'm not having the best friends or the best relationship, or I feel stuck in my career, and then it can manifest in the physical, because you're 3 years unhappy with your job, right? You are unhappy, and then you stop your hobby as well. You stop going out, and like you don't have social interactions anymore because it drags you down so much. So it's with everyone it's different, and it has sometimes like or most of the time multiple problems, right? It's not just one thing. And Yeah, you know, a lot of trauma is created when we are from 0 to 7 years old. Okay. That's where we are having the biggest receiving for, like, trauma can be saved in that time a lot because we are more open, kind of. We don't have so much boundaries or, you know, something like that. And so it's a lot about that as well. Like,
were you looking at the source of someone's, for example, how they're raised? What interaction like did they go through? Did their parents go through a divorce at that point in their life? Did they have a sickness or an illness? Was there something else going on in their family? Did they have to move a lot? So that can, like you had said, can imprint a big part of their emotion that gets unconscious and becomes part of their physicality, where now they're expressing that if you want to call it a negative emotion, different emotion, through their life, maybe in their 20s and 30s or 40s. So at that point, they have to, and I'm not going to remember what happened at 6 7 years old, but you can, as you can, that can bring that up, but also said release it, not just keep going over and over again where it causes you to feel bad every time you talk about it.
Yeah, totally. It's like you have to kind of like time travel back to the roots, to the age. I can detect, okay, I can just test, is it from 0 to 10 from the age, or is it from 10 to 20? When did it originate? Where did it start? And then I can go there and I can see what belief is it. Okay, I have charts with like 50 beliefs on it, and then I can just test out which one it is. Or like the emotions, it's the same, it's a chart with 60 emotions. And I can just then find out what's the emotion. For example, it's resentment, okay? Or suppressing emotions is another big thing. Like if you don't feel them, right? If you don't let them out, if you just swallow everything, like that, that's how disease is manifested as well. You know, and then we release that, and then your life can change, because then you don't think about that situation all the time. You don't be angry about it anymore. You change your beliefs and you get lighter on it. You can forget yourself and that person, you know, like you had this big mess with your dad or whatever, and it keeps coming in your adult life, and then you just make it lighter for you, and then you can forget about it, kind of, or even love yourself or your dad, or have understanding why that happened, okay? And then you can change what you attract in your life, and you can change how your perception is of yourself, other people, and then, you know, get closer to what you should be doing, like being happy, following your soul purpose, following your heart, all those things. And it's amazing. Like for me, it turned my life upside down. Like I was very sick and I was depressed and anxious, and you know, I was bullied a lot when I was younger, and you know, like it's amazing. Like it changed my whole life upside down, and that's why I do it, because I've been there, and I've seen it change so fast. With nothing else, like the psychotherapy, for example, was like, some people need it. I don't want to disregard it, of course, yeah. But for me, it was not the right way.
Well, I like how you something that I would know is psychotherapy. Okay, how does that work? Like you had mentioned, you find out what the emotion is, when it happened when a kid, and you bring it to the surface, but you never really release it. So then, even though you may stop psychotherapy, it's always in your head. It's always in your subconscious. So it's always going to be there. So it seems like it would be more work to keep that, if you want to call it, in your subconscious and still work on everything else. Well, like you had mentioned, why not release it, get it out of your head, then focus on what you want out of your new life, even though that may have happened, understand it and let it go, versus keep bringing it up over and over again as the problem.
Yeah, totally. Perfect.
If people use that maybe as an excuse to go, I'm going to use that as an excuse, why do I keep falling back, versus just stay here at the present and work on the present.
Yep, totally. All those traumas and these emotions, they keep you stuck in the past. Like you always, mm-hmm. like Sometimes, because I told you, it's not, you're not aware sometimes even that it keeps repeating, because if you would, you would go crazy. Like, if you would be aware of all those 100%, things would go up in, like, in the background, in the backstage, you know. But it's keeping your energy in the past and not in the here and now. So you have struggled then with your day-to-day life here, because you have this knee pain, or you feel this sadness all the time, and you know, you don't know where it comes from. And I can even release things from your ancestors. That's another thing. Like, there's it's called miasma.
How do you spell that?
It's M-I-A-S-M-A, and that's the pro term for it, but it basically means that when your grandma had asthma, it could be very high degree that you have it as well, or could develop it, kind of like this, you know, and those things I can track as well and release, because some people, they don't have those diseases because they made something wrong, or kind of like, you know, it's not from their life, because they have tried all things like acupuncture, yoga, meditation, energy healing, whatever, everything for years, and they can't seem to figure it out. And then that's another way, you know, it could not be from your life, it could be passed down and unhealed from your ancestors even. So I can then detect, is it from your mom's line or from your dad's line, and how many generations is it back, right?
Wow. Yeah, and what I'm doing too is I'm taking a lot of notes on what you're talking about, so I'm putting you on paper, Sebastian, and using that down the line as a podcast and everything else too. So I want to make sure I have the right information from you. Like, you have, you've been very, what I like about your interview, you're very honest, you're very smooth talking, and it allows us to really see how you're helping people from a very simplistic perspective, but a different way to understand psychology, different approach to psychology, which I love, because people don't get that. People are told, bury it, keep it there, but let's deal with everything else here, but it's always going to go back to that. So you're making people's lives easier by releasing it first and then focusing on, you're not allowing the past to stay in the present.
Yeah. You know, you got to let out the stuff, you got to feel it, you got to... Because otherwise, if you just suppress and swallow all the time, then, you know, you don't go anywhere. Like, you keep getting slower, and then, you know, the diseases manifest. You know, of course, it can happen as well through toxins or through accident as well, of course, you know. But those chronic diseases, they are these everyday things where you think, oh, it's just fine when I keep forgetting about it, or I just suppress it and I don't listen to my body, you know. Like, your body is your friend, you know, he's here to help you. Like, if you have pain, you gotta change something. Like, it's calling you to look and listen and think, like, okay, what am I doing? Why might I have this? Or, you know, you gotta look, listen more to your intuition, to your heart and gut, right? It's a seed of wisdom where, like, it's crazy how much information you can gather if you really dare to be silent and listen. And, you know, like, I was the same. Like, I was always, like, searching outside for everything. And I was overeating and, you know, like, not taking care of anything. and I was mad at my body, and I was thinking, like, why is that, you know? But, you know, a lot of things are upside down. You can just turn them around, like, that they you know, the opposite is almost true, what they tell you, everything, you know, in the school and in the media. So we have to be self-reliant, okay? Don't be reliant on the system or on other practitioners. It's even for me, I say, or I write down that I'm an energy healer, but I don't heal the people. I just detect the blockages and I heal the blockages. We release the blockages. So, you know, then the body of themselves, they can heal themselves. So I don't do that for them. And I encourage them to to you know, change their life, but it automatically happens because we change the emotions and the beliefs. So it's usually just a few sessions there with me, like 1 to 10 sessions, you know, depending on whatever you want or need. But it's not like a system where I keep them, like, you know, like stuck and you have to be there all the time every week. Like, we get results. We don't talk, kind of like we clear the stuff and we go to the root, you know.
And once you get there, and once you get them to clear everything out, and you start working the positive emotions, what type of things do you give them to start working on to get and maintain that positive emotional state?
Sure. Well, you know, what I find is very important is doing meditation or walking alone in, like, the nature to connect to yourself, because, like, you process a lot subconsciously even when you are alone or in meditation, or you know the active meditation where you walk alone in the nature, and then you connect to yourself, and then your body is telling you through your feelings and your thoughts, or your soul or your higher self or whatever, like what can you do next? You know, you will be guided. Like, there's an inner wisdom, and you know, I always say follow your heart, like, it knows everything, your soul purpose. Everyone knows what they would like to do, but they always have these excuses, you know. I had the same, like, I always, yeah, like, you know, but this, but that, but. So, you know, you got to start somewhere, and we always know the first step, I think. We just try to make a too big of a step, right? And we don't always have to do the things business-wise or sole purpose, for example. We can do it also on the hobby, you know. What do you can just ask yourself, what is making you the most joy or the most fun, or what do you love the most? Those questions.
Yeah.
Right. And we always, everyone knows it, because we do it, like, we do it sometimes, but just gotta be quiet, and it comes everything to you. Like, don't search outside. Like, stop that phone, you know. Like, go in the nature a weekend with your friends, and that's the best doctor ever, you know.
Yeah. I like that, yeah. You keep it very simple. I did talk with a guy who's a happy expert, and he says a lot of it is right here. It's all in your head already. What we have to do by allowing it to ourselves to look inside allows us all to really understand we have all the answers. But by using the words like but or if or things like that, the limiting beliefs, we block ourselves from hearing ourselves, block us from knowing what's already inside our body, help us heal. And I like going into nature, being by ourselves allows us to re-energize and get ourselves away from all the stressors, all the media, everything, everyone else telling you what to do, versus listening to just your own voice.
Yep. You know, yeah, totally. You know, we have it all in us. We just have to train that access again. Like, we got to make that bridge again. We got to build it again. For me, it's still a process. I'm not there yet, you know, but I'm a lot better than 5 years ago. And it's, everything is trainable. Energy goes where attention flows, right? So you create your own reality, right? And if you don't change those subconscious beliefs, it just keeps happening and happening and happening, right?
I like what you said too. Energy goes where attention flows. By being attentive to yourself and what your self needs are, allows you to not be susceptible to what people think you should do, or what your the pressures of your environment, or your peer pressure, or social pressure, whatever it might be. You're able to focus on that, then make that your primary goal. Take care of yourself. Once you take care of yourself, then your energy to other people will be more loving, will be more caring, more grateful. So even though you may have back experience with someone in the past, you understand what happened, now you can move forward and move away from that. So how many people do you know? I have 10 people in my head right now that can't get out of the past.
Yeah,
and at that point, your whole present is being affected, the whole future is being affected.
Yeah.
So it's phenomenal. It's great.
Yeah, like for me, what I always liked and helped me was I heard this in a comedian, like a comedian said this following thing, like a few years ago, I think 6 years ago, I heard this. And then I was starting to live by that sentiment. It was like, okay, everyone kind of like wants to do that, but then they kind of like stop. But I don't have money, but I cannot do this, mm-hmm. but you're right. And when I hear myself, I say, but I just stop right there. And I say, okay, I try it once. And then I know if it's for me or not. And, you know, that's the same with energy healing. When I was first a client, mm-hmm. like everyone knows, oh, that's just hocus pocus or, you know, like, well, it's not proven scientifically. And I just released that and I just said, okay, I'm going to do one session with her and then I'm going to feel into it. And if it helps me, I just keep doing it, right? Or see something similar. And if it doesn't, then I can still say, okay, I got to move on and find something else. But like, we got to release those judgments, what we have imprinted on us. You got to switch off that media, to be honest. Like,
good.
Because they program you there, like, all the time. And, like, get your own experts. Like, I learned a lot from listening to podcasts when I was younger. I started when I was 16. Like, YouTube podcasts, it's really great if you have the right kind of people to follow. Like, it's better than you know, all these mass media thing. Because that's a trap, you know, it's a trap.
What's fun, it's listening to enough things also too, that you know what's a trap, what's trying to sell you something versus what's trying to help you. And like you're doing too here, it's going through your own personal experiences, what I went through, this is what's helped me. So people, like some people will say, even with chiropractic, I'm a chiropractor. Some people will try it. Some people will go, they already have their belief system. It doesn't work. It's fake, whatever it is too. I go, hey, that's fine. I have enough people like you're doing now that I listen to my content to go, hey, look, this guy's on here enough. He explains what's going on. I'll give it a try. And once someone gives it a try, then you give them the experience to go, that's what I'm looking for. This is what I really felt looking for. If you're helping people, you are, Sebastian, avoid that chronic years of therapy that doesn't help them, the years of chronic pain that they can't find a solution for. They do MRIs, even cut stuff out of their body. They feel better, doesn't fix the problem. You're saving them all that time, that energy, that money, and all that grief and physical pain. So I would for you, if it was me, keep working at it. Keep getting your name out there. Keep getting your word out there to help more people see you as a way to help them heal inside and out and get them to see a different way, heal their own body, and then maintain that healing by looking at themselves. By doing the right, in their sense, the homework of meditation and self, if you want to call it being with self, either at home or in nature, somewhere we can get away from all the chaos, everything around you, and then maintain that healthy state so your body stays healthy, right? That's the plan.
Yep.
I mean, in my sense, I call it being your best doctor. You're your best doctor.
Yep. The forest, the nature, yourself, mm-hmm. and you know, mm-hmm. Like, okay, I have another thing for you. The autonomous nervous system, like mm-hmm. like your digestion, you don't turn your digestion on by thinking of it. It goes automatic. It's called automatic nervous system, right? Like, mm-hmm. how are you supposed to know where to move, how to move, what muscles to tense, everything? Like, you have a whole wisdom, a whole system into you, your whole body. Like, it's a perfect machine, you know, or like, you know, it has everything. It can heal itself. We just got to release those blocks and find them, and then it can heal itself again. And, you know, like, that's so beautiful.
Well, the biggest thing is that me and you are in the same page sense where I was looking at your bio too, where the body is self-healing, self-regulating. The problem is modern medicine says it is not. And because I don't have the millions of dollars that drug companies have to promote that it is not, we have to do our part here on YouTube, on Facebook, on social media, and even in person too, to put the word out there that it is, get back to that. It's been around for thousands of years before medicine was invented, to get our bodies to stay self-healing, self-reliant, and stay within self to keep our bodies healthy, right?
Yep, you gotta be your own authority. Okay, get your power back, and when someone else is like, even you have to get a close look to your friends. Okay, like, are they really in your highest and best good? Are they supporting you, or are they just there to, you know, don't be alone or whatever, just to get some time going? Like, yep. Are they really bringing the best out in you? Are they supporting you in whatever you do or say? Right? You got to get yourself a good social community as well. And if you get a no to this, then you got to just change it. Like, there's so many people, like, maybe you just start then to find yoga or meditation, and you just go to that place where they offer once a week, they do together a group meditation, mm-hmm. and then you find new people there. They are up your alley and are interested in your new things, right? Because if you stay in that same circle, you won't get, like, it's Albert Einstein has had that saying, like, if you do the same things over and over again, it's crazy or madness to expect that things will turn out differently. Right? You gotta change. You gotta change what you think and do to change your life as well. If you just do all the same all the time, it will be all the same all the time, right? But you just mm-hmm. can also, like, ask for it, like get it out there. You write down what you want, what you wish, right? That's good for you, also for the higher powers that are, you know, invisible, God, creator, whatever. And then it will help you to, like, there's a power, everyone knows that there's a power working, you know, like, invisible around us. Like, most people have, you know, like, these protective angels. Like, some people just have this accident and they're like, oh, almost, you know, but I had this protective angel, or, you know, like, it's really there. And when we know what we want and we ask for it, we word it or we write down, that's mm-hmm. better for us as well. Like, we have focused on what we want and we've written it out, and we learn from that as well. Like, we are more determined and we're not wishy-washy because we just have it in our head. So that helps us to change and attract things as well. And that's another thing, what people can do, like this thankful list, like 5 things before you sleep, 5 things you write down. What are you thankful for this day, right? Oh, I had this amazing meal. Someone cooked for me, you know, or, you know, this lady in the grocery store, she was super nice. She smiled at me. And if you are thankful for those things, you will attract more of that, right? Because you shift your attention, energy flows where attention goes, so you shift your attention to the positive things, what you're grateful for, and you don't keep thinking about that past relationship that just was not good. And then, because if you get energy there, then you just keep attracting those relationships, right? Rather focus on what else you want. Focus on what you want, not what you don't want, right?
I like that too, is where, well, when you, because an event, when you go to the store, right, it's an event. But how you perceive that event, how you see the event, can be either positive or negative. And if you keep in your mindset in a positive mindset throughout the day, when you sleep, when you wake up in the morning, when you're doing all three, then the body can stay healthy overall. I think when we do that, then our body stays healthy, then our mind stays healthy also. Everything works together. And by doing that, then long term, we can avoid injuries, we can avoid sickness, we can avoid our body getting sick if our body is actually having the positive mindset throughout the day through affirmations, writing it down, through saying it for one, too, having our routine every day. As some people have a routine of turning the TV on, watching the news, I'd rather have the routine of reading affirmations, of reading positive things, sleeping that way, and then waking up and doing the same thing. So my whole day is perceived as a positive and thankful event.
Yeah, man, I did those affirmations as well. They are great. It works. Yeah, you know, I was listening to them like very slow, low volume when I was sleeping. I put them on.
Good.
And I was doing that for 3 months, and after three weeks, I started already to feel different inside, and I started to believe what they are actually saying in that affirmation. Like before, I was like, what? This sounds crazy. What? Like, what? Yeah. I deserve money. Like, I deserve happiness and all those things. Like, it was a bit a block at the beginning, and then I was like, yeah, of course I deserve that. You know, like. Sure, like, you know, your one, like, just imagine, like, when your mom and dad made love, you are one of, I don't know, millions or billions, right? You are the one. You are the one who made it.
You made it through the egg sac. Good job. You made it through.
Yep. So, like, I don't know. You already you come here to Earth. Everyone is already enough. You don't have to be or do anything. Like, why? Like, why?
Release it. Just release it. Start over. Yeah.
Yeah.
You got it.
Everyone has their gifts, you know, and if everyone can follow their gifts, like their heart, and find out what it is, what they can share, like, this would be such a beautiful place, you know, and that is my mission, kind of. Why I do my work or do those podcasts to encourage people to listen to their heart, right? Because I always had this knowing that no, this is not it. This physio thing is not it. This electrician thing is not it. Like, there has to be something else. And I always followed that inner voice. It was very, very low volume at the beginning, but it kept growing, and I'm really grateful I did that, but it was not easy, of course, but
if it's easy, everyone would do it, right? So it makes it better for, I think there's more value involved when we put the hard work in. It becomes concrete part of our truth versus something we go back and forth with. So keep our truth positive allows us overall to stay in that mindset, like you said, not only to learn, become a student of health healing, of energy healing, but also now a teacher of energy healing as you put more information out there. So not only you're helping people understand the practice of it, but also how to become their own energy healer. Also, once they're through everything, then how do you continue to have that community and you having it too? I correlate it with people going to a meditation studio. Even like a yoga studio too. They're a group of people looking to stay in that mindset. So not only is Johnny and Sally part of it, but also now their energy level, when someone's not feeling well, they can sense that and go, hey, what's going on? We missed you yesterday. Is everything okay? So you have that focus group of people that want to care for you to stay healthy too. That's both.
Yeah. Awesome. That would be
same
awesome.
Same page, my friend. Anything else for your show today? I think you did a great job. I think we brought it all together. I think we're on the same page. There is an energy. We call it, the chiropractors call it, the power that makes the body, heals the body. It's a power. It's energy. We don't need a name for it. We just know what it is. And it's around us all the time. It's around us since we were a soul, since we were born. It's with us. It's listening to it, letting our body hear it for what it is.
Yep. It's... Everything is energy. That my dear friend, my past dear friend, that everything is energy. Money is energy. Illness is energy. It's just blocked energy. It's stuck. And smile is energy. Like, you know, everything. And it cannot go anywhere. It can just be trapped, or you can just release it. And, you know, like, you gotta... Like, everything matters, like your whole feelings and thoughts, and you got to be really aware. And if you catch yourself, you just say, okay, that's fine. And then I do better. I raise my standards of excellence to do better every day, you know?
Good.
And step by step, like, don't be, like, hard on yourself. Everyone has their own pace, right? Be patient. Everything will unfold perfectly at the right time.
That's it, my friend. Well, thank you. Thank you for the show. Anything else to add? I have all your links in my in the show notes on Facebook. Put them on YouTube. Everywhere. Put them on the podcast. Do down the line. Phenomenal work, my friend. Thank you.
Thank you so much.